Hello, my name is Kwa. I am a graduated student. I graduated a semester early, and this fall I will be attending grad school for my master's of public health. There are some spoilers to what schools I got into, where I committed in this video. So if you want to, please go watch my previous video for my school reactions. And yeah, so let's get started. Okay, on to stats and profile. So I went to the University of Minnesota Twin Cities for my undergrad, where I graduated in 3.5 years. I did my Bachelor of Arts in Human Physiology with minors in Integrative Neuroscience and Public Health. So my undergrad experience is very like STEM heavy, like lots of biology classes, chemistry, etc. And then supplemented with my neuroscience and public health minors. So that's kind of what I did in undergrad for my stats. So I had a 3.42 GPA when I finished from the University of Minnesota, which is like, maybe it's like around average or below average for Masters of Public Health candidates, for their undergrad GPA, that is. I think for Columbia, the average GPA was 3.55 for undergrad profiles, so I was a bit under average. So that's for GPA. For the GRE, I did not take the GRE. It was optional, especially with COVID. A lot of schools waived it, so a lot of schools don't even consider it to be submitted, so I just didn't take it, and which was that was pretty good because I don't like standardized testing. So yep, that's like mostly it for stats. Okay, so for the rest of my profile, I pull up my notes really quick. So okay, so I did like a variety of things throughout undergrad. Freshman year, I was a photographer for my school, just like a job, and then I joined and then became a board member for pre-pharmacy club. Thing is, I used to be pre-pharmacy, and I switched to pre-med and I switched to public health, so a lot of my experiences kind of reflect like that medical journey, I guess. Like I was in a neuroscience journal club, I was a TA for a biology colloquium class. I did research, I think around 500 hours of undergrad research in cardiovascular physiology. I volunteered at different hospitals, my school's hospital, the VA, got some clinical hours, patient care hours. None of this is like really like required for public health. It's just kind of what I had because I was pre-pharm and pre-med. Let's see, I worked for an AAPI resource center. That was like something that I wrote about a lot in my profile, in my application, because it meant a lot to me and I got to do a lot of things. I was in a variety of cultural clubs like the Vietnamese Student Association of Minnesota, the Asian American Student Union. Yeah, so gender and sexuality center. So yeah, like quite a few clubs involved. I was involved as a mentor for those clubs as well. So that was my leadership. Yeah. And then I'm trying to think. I also did some volunteering with Vietnamese Social Services, where I kind of like helped translate. I also got a certification so I can teach English to Vietnamese immigrants and other immigrants in the Twin Cities area. And yeah, so I was kind of involved in a variety of things throughout my undergrad. And when it came to my application, I think the lack of like public health research or internships kind of made me a little concerned, which is also why I applied to like 12 schools. But it all worked out in the end. I think my most important tip is that in your personal statement and your writing, whenever you answer questions, definitely like try to connect your experiences to public health in some way. So for example, my work at Vietnamese Social Services, I was able to like do a bilingual workshop on mental health and on the flu and COVID, did some presentations. And then my work at the API Resource Center, I also like led a lot of workshops and events that are focused on mental health, like the public health side of mental health, on COVID, etc. So I think like connecting your experiences to public health somehow make them like relevant. It's kind of the key, and that really helped me like solidify my application despite not having any public health internships or research. Yeah. Okay, so for the last part of this video, I'm trying to keep it as short as possible. I have some tips for the application process. So I use SOFAS. Let me figure out what it stands for. SOFAS is the Schools of Public Health Application Service. So if you did the Common App for applying to undergrad, it's kind of like that, basically. So it's like a whole like application, and it has like most of the schools of public health in it that you can just apply to all at once. You just have to have like different essays and different questions for them. Yeah. So I use SOFAS, and also like check like if the school you're applying to, they might have a supplemental application, or they might only be available like outside of SOFAS. So I'll keep that in mind. Out of my 12 schools, I think only one school had a supplemental application where I had to do on their own portal. And that was University of Washington in Seattle. And yeah, so I just used SOFAS. I got 3 letters of recommendations from my professors and my boss. Sent in my official transcripts from my undergrad university, and then a university where I did like dual enrollment in during high school. So they're gonna need all of your history, so make sure you have that in mind if you did like community college or any other college or university before your like your main university. Then you need to send in all of those official transcripts. Yeah, I'm trying to think of what else. Can't think of anything. But I will be happy to answer some questions in the comments as well. That's for anything that's not covered in this video. But yeah, that was my stats, EC's application. And I'm very excited to go to Columbia this fall. So yeah.